Hello and welcome to the Quirky Inquiry. And in this short video, I want to make a video on how to best, decipher and to understand some of the stuff in philosophical texts. Because there's a problem out there. There's a common problem out there for people when they pick up one of these books, when they pick up one of these really complex and philosophical books. They tend to read a couple pages and they give up. Why? Because these books are some of the most difficult, some of the most challenging, and some of the most mentally strenuous books that you would ever encounter upon. Immediately we have a problem, right? Immediately we have a problem. If so many people are running away from these sorts of texts, if so many people are not trying to understand these texts, and if so many people are not really learning the lessons from these texts, or if so many people are trying to find out the easy way, if so many people are trying to seek out simplified explanations, most of the nuances within these books are not really understood. Most of the key points that the author is delivering are usually misinterpreted, right? So in this video, I aim to address this problem of not understanding philosophical texts, and I want to present you one technique of how exactly to properly understand this thing using a very simple and a very easy and also a very kind of a, I find it kind of fun to read philosophical texts in this way. So the central problem here is that most people tackle these texts not as philosophical texts. They tackle this thing like a novel. Have you ever wondered why these books are so small? Have you ever wondered why some of the best philosophical books out there are written in a very short format? Have you ever wondered why? It is because the author is trying to succinctly and eloquently punch in as many layers of meaning as possible in each one of the presented sentences, right? This is like poetry right here. Each sentence contains perhaps 7 or 8 dimensions of meaning. And you, your job as a reader of philosophy and your job as a studier, active studier of philosophy, is not to experience the text. If you want to experience some text, go pick up something like Harry Potter. That's a text that you enjoy and you read for the enjoyment of itself, but not for one of these. One of these books are gonna take you more mental strain, gonna take you more mind processing power, and it is gonna be a lot more painful to read than your ordinary fiction or ordinary Lord of the Rings books. So you really have to tackle these books not from a standpoint of entertainment. You don't read this kind of stuff for entertainment, although some of you, if you really love philosophy, tackle it from a point of entertainment. But also remember that you have to read for understanding. You have to read for understanding instead of experience. Right? You have to understand it. Otherwise, if you go through this book passively, you can only understand about 10% of the author's contention. So tackle this book from an understanding point of view. Take more time to process the texts. Take more time to process the words. And also take more time to decipher the meaning. Actively think. What I do is that I usually get on the bus. I just read one short passage. After I read the passage, I actively think about it, right? Maybe I would only get through one passage per day. One short passage per day. And for the rest of the day, I'll be thinking about it. I'll be actively trying to fit this new piece of knowledge with my previous knowledge. This is called elaborative rehearsal in psychology, which really brings your understanding of the text to a whole deeper level. So in a nutshell, aim for understanding instead of raw, just passively going through it. Instead of trying to read this thing like a novel, read it for understanding. So with regards to the technique of how actually to decipher some of these texts, I have a really powerful technique to share with you. Ideally, if you want to truly understand this book, you need to read it out loud. And ideally, if you have friends around, have some of your friends that are also interested in philosophy, read it with you. Read this book out loud with some philosophical friends of yours around you. So what that does is that as you read it out loud, you're gonna get a whole deeper understanding of the text. And of course, with all your friends around you, you can have active discussions. You can have active interpretations, right? Your friends will offer you different perspectives to look at this specific passage. Your friends, they have different paradigms and values. And then you can base all your arguments and base all your discussions upon that one passage. So literally what I meant here, or what I said right there, it's kind of to imitate philosophers in the past. Philosophy is not some activity that a lone academic that locks himself in a room. That's not what philosophy is about. Philosophy really is about discussion. Philosophy is about not being a dogmatist and not getting oneself locked in his own paradigm. So I think a really great way to do this is to gather a bunch of friends together that are interested in philosophy, have one of them open up the book and read it out loud, and then you guys can spend the next 10 to 20 minutes deciphering that passage, having active arguments, and you would be quite surprised what's going to come out of that discussion. Your friends are going to offer you new perspectives and new thoughts and new ideas that you never ever considered before. And judging, you know, basing off of the work of David Hume, you cannot reason outside of the web of your reasoning. If you cannot get out of your own paradigm, your friends are going to help you to propel you out of your own paradigm, because they have new perspectives, new ideas, and new thoughts that you can take with you to integrate into your worldview and integrate into your understanding of the text. So yeah, that was a pretty rapid-fire video. I've tackled basically what I wanted to tackle. I've basically addressed this question once and for all, and that was a pretty good technique. So yeah, that was the video for today. Hope you guys liked it, and be sure to click the like button for me, subscribe to the channel if you want, and of course, keep reading, keep expanding, keep thinking, and I'll see you guys in the next video.